Dear professional friends, in this video I am going to discuss about whether an auditor remark is a qualification or disclosure. To determine it, the auditor of a company has given qualification in the audit report as follows. The company had provided depreciation in respect of fixed assets at the rates prescribed under Income Tax Act, which are at variance with the rates prescribed under Companies Act. However, this does not affect the accounting results or valuation of asset in balance sheets in a material manner, since the company has been following the practice since its inception, which are at variance with the rates prescribed under the Companies Act 1956. The board can reply as follows. The auditor's view are self-explanatory. The board of director shall take necessary steps toward depreciation calculation as per Companies Act in the following financial year. During the current financial year, the company can calculate the depreciation as per Companies Act and pause the entry for difference between Income Tax Act and Companies Act. However, some professionals argue that when what auditor has stated is just a disclosure and not a qualification or reservation or adverse remark, so directors need not to comment on the same. In notes to accounts, company should mention the details about the deviation with regard to depreciation. Directors report, either the company can reproduce notes in this regard or it can mention the word auditor's remarks, if any, suitably explained in the notes to accounts under note number dash dash. However, it is to be noted that what auditor has stated is just a disclosure, qualification or reservation with respect to depreciation. The depreciation rates under Schedule 14 are minimum rates and the company may charge higher rates. So the directors need not give comment on such a disclosure. Not even the like board of directors will take care of the same from coming financial year, and as far as previous year is concerned, there is no any difference in valuation of depreciation. So the directors need not give comment on such disclosure. Not even like board of directors will take care of the same from coming financial year, and as far as previous year is concerned, there is no any difference in valuation of depreciation. The comment given by the auditor is not a qualification at all. The auditor has also stated that the company is following this practice since its inception, and so it shall not be good to say that the company will follow it in the forthcoming financial year also. Even in this next financial year, the auditor may give the same comment. It is better not to give any explanation. This is the answer to the above question. How Board of Comet Hotels India Limited recalled excess remuneration paid to its managing director due to pressure from lenders. A very rare situation has happened. A very rare decision taken by the Board of Comet Hotels India Limited, where most of the companies have obtained shareholders' consent for waiver of recovery of excess managerial remuneration paid. The company has paid remuneration to Dr. Mittal V. Comet, Executive Chairman and Managing Director, for the financial year 31st March 2020, which is in excess of the limits prescribed under Section 197 of the Companies Act 2013, read with Schedule 5, by 41.94 lakhs. Which was highlighted by the auditors in the board meeting held on 30th July 2020, and the waiver of the same was subject to approvals from the secured lenders and the members. However, subsequent to the approval of the audited accounts for the year ended 31st March 2020, based on the discussion held by the management with the secured lenders at the meeting of the board of directors held on 28th August 2020, the board of the Comet Hotels decided not to approach lenders for their NOC, which is a prime condition before approaching member for waiver of excess remuneration paid, and instead directed to start the recovery process from the Mittal V. Comet, and until the sum is fully recovered, the Mittal V. Comet still holds the excess payment of remuneration ₹97.97 lakhs. Interest for the company. So this is very good example, good standard of policy followed by the company. So the company don't want to pay excess remuneration to the managing directors since it is opposed by the secured lenders, and they are taken a U-turn now. Friends, I think you like this video. If you like it, I request you to please subscribe my channel. Thanking you once again, R.V. Shekhar, practicing company secretary.